takes us out of the AutoZone keys to victory.
Well, for Morrison, use discretion. Don't get too crazy, but still get a KO. He really needs that to help pump up the fight he has with Herbie Hyde. For Puritty, slow the tempo. Don't get into a slugging match with him. And the straight right, that's the punch Tommy Morrison is very vulnerable to.
Ross Puritty has had to get his boxing education in the ring. He was a football player, did not really have an amateur career. So it's kind of on-the-job training for him, and it has not been the easiest way to go.
It's been kind of up and down, but, you know, as he said, I got out of football, I got right into boxing, and he said, if nothing else, boxing paid for my college education. And he said that is something, at least, that they can never take away from him.
Tommy Morrison comes into the ring now. Morrison now fighting out of Tulsa, Oklahoma, as we mentioned. Had his last fight back in May, a win over Sherman Griffin. And now, again, we've mentioned he's a guy who seems to take two steps forward and one giant step backward. And right now he's in a forward mode and aims to stay that way. This time he says he means it. Let's get up to Ed Darien.
We are back at the Convention Center here in Atlantic City, New Jersey, as Top Rank Incorporated and Budweiser, the king of beers, in association with the Casino Association of New Jersey, proudly present Top Rank Boxing and is approved by the New Jersey State Athletic Control Board, the Honorable Larry Hazard, Senior Commissioner, the Honorable Jerry Gormley, Chairman. Members of the board include Gary Shaw and Al Daniels, Sr. Our judges, John Potteray, Shafiq Rashada, and Frank Brunette. In the ring at this time, the man in charge of the scheduled 10-round heavyweight bout, referee Frank Cappuccino. And now, boxing fans, introducing the principals. First, in the red corner, wearing the green trunks with the black trim. He weighed in at an even 242 pounds. This young man hails from Norman, Oklahoma. Has 11 wins, 8 losses with 8 knockouts. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to Atlantic City, New Jersey, Ross Puritty. Puritty. And his opponent in the blue corner, wearing the black and red trim trunks. He weighed in at an even 225 pounds. This young man is a native of Jake, Oklahoma, and now residing in Tulsa, Oklahoma. He has 41 wins, 2 losses with 35 knockouts. The former WBO heavyweight champion of the world, ladies and gentlemen, here is Tommy the Duke Morrison. Morrison.
Gentlemen, you were both given your instructions by the New Jersey Control Board. Protect yourself at all times, touch gloves.
Here's a look at Ross Puritty, the ex-football player who actually does look like he's coming here pretty fit. And he'll have to be, because without question, he's in there against a banger in Tommy Morrison. Morrison at 225. It's about the weight he's been fighting at the last couple of fights.
I hope Ross Puritty doesn't expect to get a decision tonight.
No, forget it.
I guess if you're an underdog, you don't get one, period, huh?
The knockout percentage and much higher, as you might expect, from Tommy Morrison. Nobody has ever questioned Tommy Morrison's ability to bang.
A tremendous left hook. And that one just missed by last smidge.
Good body shot, and then a right hand behind it.
You know, so far already, though, you have to look at Morrison. He's throwing quick punches. You know, when he's on, his punches are quick. And it gives him extra power. It's when they're ponderous and real wide that he's not very effective. The early part of the fight is so important for Ross Puritty, obviously. You got to get through the onslaught, which is always there for Morrison. Nice uppercut by Ross Puritty.
He looks off his heels. Now he bounces off the ropes and attacks.
And he's slapping with the left hook, but he's landing against Morrison.
Yeah, got another uppercut in.
Wow. Ross Ross Puritty, a delightful guy to talk to, has a degree from UTEP where he played football for 4 years in advertising and marketing.
Get him loose, get him loose, get him loose.
And he said, candidly, I got nothing to lose in this fight.
He does have some skills. It's, as we said, he's learning as he's doing this. Took a left hand from Morrison. One thing about Ross Puritty, he does look in very good shape.
We last saw him against Kirk Johnson in May in Los Angeles. He ended up losing that fight, was hit with repeated low blows. They did take a point away from Kirk Johnson, but he still ended up losing. Defense by Puritty.
I was just going to say, those punches being caught on the arms, on the shoulders.
Would you wait? You're walking.
All right, stop punching and step back. Both of them.
Good right hand by Tommy Morrison, but Puritty's still there.
Has gotten through the 3 minutes, and we'll be back.
Here is where Ross Puritty did some work and get off the ropes, but it wasn't very effective. It's interesting, it looked more effective when we saw it from a certain angle. However, it turned out not to be that good when you look at it in replay.
And Morrison did land a very good right hand toward the end of that round. Pretty good round by and large for Tommy Morrison. Here are the punches in the first round. As you see, Morrison pretty high connect percentage. Both got there with left hands that time.
You know, it's interesting. Morrison is leaving himself open for the hook, but Puritty is not a big hooker.
Hooked him right there.
Yeah. And Puritty's getting the uppercut in. That's another punch that we have seen Morrison hit with from time to time as he leans in.
Puritty looks like he's looking to counter punch.
Now, Tommy Morrison, of course, came in here at 225. He says he'd like to get down a little bit more, but he says he's in good condition because he said that before, during times when maybe he wasn't. So would Ross Puritty benefit from taking him into the later rounds? I'm sure he feels that way. Well, Morrison says, who, by the way, already has some blood from his nose, he says he really would like a few more rounds in this fight.
Probably a good idea for Puritty to get his back off the ropes. He's fought in that posture quite a lot. Another left hand from Morrison.
Dude, the hook of Purity's getting it. He just slaps with it, though. That punch is really there for Puritty. Ross Puritty is keeping his mind on business. He is not awed by the punching power so far of Morrison. He's covering up well. He's countering pretty well.
Get them hands loose. You're holding. You're
He's making this competitive.
Break! Break!
Tommy Morrison has a tendency, if things don't go well for him early on, he sometimes gets a little frustrated. Most of those were caught on the gloves.
Morrison doing the right thing by jabbing his way in, though. That's how he wants to make things start.
It's just a heavy-handed puncher, Tommy Morrison. There's just no question about that, but he took a combination of security. End of round two. Round number three. Round number two was 2 minutes and 53 seconds long.
I shan't comment.
No.
week out with a whole bunch of people who are out after our jobs
at the National Sportscasters Camp that you and Dan Bellamy put together. It was a great time. Had a lot of fun. Tommy Morrison's having some fun.
Not too much. He's taking a couple of shots from Ross Puritty right here.
I'm going to send our best wishes out to all the campers there. They, a lot of talented young people who will get far in this business. It's a rewarding experience.
Three good shots from Morrison. Back Puritty out.
And he is ripping him with those bottles.
Oh, what a left hand by Morrison. Puritty in big trouble. Morrison will keep him pinned in the corner as Puritty tries to cover up. Another big right hand. Puritty just can't get out of that corner.
Remember Michael Bent. He just, the left hook just landed on Morrison. So don't write Puritty off just yet. Morrison has just spent himself.
And Puritty does not appear to be shaken any longer.
He was hurt, but now he is clear-eyed.
Wow.
How he stayed up after that one left hook, I will not know. Just put his hands on his on his knees as if like a basketball player before he shoots a free throw, saying, I'm gonna take a rest here. He could have been in. Nice, nice combination. The right hook to the body and then to the head.
Your own in a hoops contest against people, pardon the expression, half your age.
Pretty good youngsters playing basketball. That was the culmination of my session there. It was a lot of fun. And you're doing a great service by having them for the young people.
Great. We have a lot of talent in camps. Puritty winds up the round by fighting back.
Tough work for the cameraman there, huh?
Oh, boy. Hung in there, though, didn't he?
Yeah. Proud of him.
Interestingly enough, both fighters have thrown the same amount of punches, but Morrison has landed 30 some more.
At the end of the last round, Ross Puritty was throwing himself at the time. Morrison throwing lots of punches.
Get off him, Ross. Get off him. Get off him, Ross. Break.
Got hit with about as good a shot as Tommy Morrison can throw.
And, yeah, and usually when Tommy Morrison hits you with a left hook like that, you're going to go down.
Both these are holding. Stop. Step back. Step back.
You said that Tommy Morrison wanted rounds. He's the number four right now.
Get out again.
When this card was announced, you had to wonder if you were going to get 14 rounds of boxing out of it. We sure do. In the first fight, not only did we get 10 rounds, but it was not only competitive. In our minds, Marion Wilson definitely won the fight, though Mercer got the result, became a draw. It's a straight right hand I talked about in the keys to victory, and it's a punch normally Morrison would be more susceptible to than the hook, though Puritty has landed the hook a lot.
Morrison boxing a little bit more this round.
Using the jab, which Tommy Vergès told him to use.
A good jab, too. Puritty's getting a little braver.
He is really pinning a lot of hopes on that uppercut. He's just barely missing in some instances and sometimes landing.
Hey!
Morrison went 10 rounds in his last fight with Sherman Griffin out of Tulsa. And of round number four, and we'll go at least into the fifth round here. Ross Puritty is still around.
And in the last round, I thought Ross Puritty had his best round of the fight, made some noises off the ropes, landed some uppercuts and good hooks.
Three, four rounds. Morrison's still with an edge, but it's not as decided an edge as it was. Slipping on the painted portion of the canvas again. We've talked about that on numerous occasions. When sweat gets on it, it's kind of shiny to begin with. We've seen an awful lot of fighters slip on it lately.
Well, last week, a couple of bad slips. Puritty's starting to use the jab now, and with some measure of success. Keeping Morrison at bay with that punch. Before Tommy was able to kind of walk right in. The Rocky Five has been making the rounds of the table again the last couple of months because Tommy Morrison played Tommy Gunn in that movie.
What part did you play? Who were you?
Well, actually, I played myself, and it was a stretch.
Typecasting again.
Yeah, yeah.
I hate that.
Well, I kept our tradition going since you were in Rocky IV.
Exactly.
I
wanted to
be, and if there's Rocky VI, VII, and VIII, we'll be in that, too. Sure. Nice body shot by Morrison. Which Morrison has not been as active as he was before.
And I think the reason is, as you pointed out, that Puritty's jab has kept him outside.
He's got a mouse underneath the right eye, a bloody nose. All is not well for Morrison.
Despite the fact he is winning the fight. End of five.
Ross Puritty, the former UTEP minor.
Played defensive tackle at about 270, now fights at about 242.
Isn't that interesting? Heavyweight fighters fall into the sort of the strong safety category amongst football.
Think about that. That's amazing.
Good work by Puritty, but he took a right hand for his head. He heard it. And Morrison is down. Seen that. Morrison's still in the Rockies. Morrison is still rocking. Good right hand for Puritty. Morrison now in the corner and another right hand. And another right hand by Puritty. And Morrison is still in trouble with 2 minutes to go in the round.
It was the uppercut that did it.
Slapping left hand. The right hand again. And Morrison's about to go again. A good right hand. Morrison in trouble again. Puritty jumps on him once more. The uppercut and a right hand pushes Morrison into the ropes. I woke him up here at the convention hall.
Morrison doing a good job of holding on right now.
Still a long way to go in round number six, and Morrison still on wobbly legs, trying to fight back. What has Puritty got left? That's the other question you got to ask.
Puritty is still looking for another uppercut. Boy, Tommy Morrison. And remember, he came back against Carla Tooth Williams after being hurt, knocked down twice.
Now, Puritty found the uppercut, but I don't believe he's as strong with his left hand as he is with his right.
No, absolutely. And that was why the right uppercut really hurt Morrison.
Good left hand from Morrison.
Puritty is tired. He's puffing from all that. And remember, Ross Puritty has never been past six rounds in his life. So this is a long way for him also at this point.
I'm not sure Tommy Morrison is still all there.
Puritty's got nothing left to throw right now.
They really let him off. 30 seconds left, sixth round.
Somewhere Herbie Hyde is breathing at least a temporary sigh of relief.
Puritty may be out of gas. There was a right hand, but it took a left hand from Morrison. And somehow Tommy Morrison has gotten through this sixth round.
Uppercut hooks are killing the guy, says Sean Gibbons. Yep, you're right, Sean. Here's an example. The uppercut and the hook. Uppercut and the hook. and that's what hurt Tommy Morrison. And then Ross Puritty got him with, yes, another uppercut. Another look, and you see what did it. Sean Gibbons absolutely correct in telling his fighter what to do. Remember, early in the fight, we talked about how the uppercut was a big punch for Puritty.
Good, good.
Morrison was smart to go down at that point.
Now let's see if Tommy Morrison doesn't try to jump right on Puritty.
Who is very tired. And again, we point out he has never seen this round. Now, Tommy Morrison could have just walked out and smacked him.
Could have done that. I think Puritty was saying there's water in the corner, and that's why he wasn't ready to get going.
Well, Ross Puritty's never seen the seventh round. He was tired toward the end of the sixth. Let's see what he has.
Of course. Talk about a survival mode.
And of those 21, a lot of them were very hard. That would be a 10-8 round, you would think, for Ross Puritty. I thought he won the round before it, but believe me, don't go by my scorecard. So far tonight, I've not been right on with the judges. Make all this begin to happen. He started using the jab two rounds ago, and that helped him land those other punches. He's not using that weapon right now.
No, I think the biggest question is, what does he have left? He looks like a tired fighter, and that's not to say that Tommy Morrison has all that left. There's the jab from Morrison. I think Morrison's going to knock Puritty out. Interesting.
Well, Puritty is certainly tired. There's no question about that. He may have expended all his energy in trying to knock Tommy Morrison out.
Looks to me like his legs are shot.
I'm going to ask, though, a tough question here. If the Ross Puritty's of the world are still knocking Tommy Morrison down, what does that say about him?
That is the scare card.
Tommy has been down many, many times in his career. Now, of course, if you keep getting up, I guess what's the difference? But in a way, there is a difference because it shows that you're vulnerable. But one thing you can't say about Tommy Morrison, he doesn't have guts. He came back to the cannons after he was knocked down that first time. I don't know how how much Morrison has left on his punching.
You know, I was just going to say, after I know that I made that statement that Morrison will knock Puritty out, that's dependent on the fact that Morrison hasn't anything left either, and I'm not sure he does.
His leverage on those punches is not that great.
He's pushing his punches a lot.
Now he's winning this round, make no mistake about that. Tommy Morrison is.
End of round number seven, and Morrison has righted things. Round number eight. Tommy Vergette saying you gotta come in with authority to his charge, Tommy Morrison. Here are the numbers through seven rounds. Morrison still with a decided edge. The sixth round was a near disaster. There was the uppercut.
Here's the posture that really Morrison doesn't want to be. He's still getting hit with those uppercuts. Puritty wants him to come in so he can counterpunch him off the rope. Morrison's actually better off in the center of the ring right now.
And a reminder that coming up next, baseball tonight, all the scores, all the highlights, everything that happened in the major leagues, and there was a lot of news out of the major leagues today. That's right after we get out.
We said at the top of the show that Ray Mercer and Tommy Morrison were trying to reinvent themselves. If you're a political spin doctor tonight, you got to work overtime to say that they did it.
Yeah, I guess it's one of those times when a win isn't necessarily a win. In fact, Ray Mercer didn't get a win.
No.
Ray Mercer didn't get a draw either.
No. And you know, if Ross Puritty wasn't essentially a six-round fighter, which he is, it's his first time going this longer distance, you'd think he would have a very good shot right now in making something big happen.
Well, you asked Tommy Morrison if he was concerned at all about looking past Ross Puritty, and he said, absolutely not. He said, I did that with Michael Benn. I'm not doing that again. And yet here he is in a fight that I'm sure is a lot tougher than he anticipated it would be.
Well, and if that's true, then it does raise even more questions about him. I've been one of those people that is not quick to write off Tommy Morrison because I think he has ability and power, but there are only so many second chances or third and fourth and fifth chances.
Both fighters getting a little bit fatigued here. Puritty actually has more bounce in his legs now than he did two rounds ago. End of round number eight, slow round on both parts. Tompkins, Al Bernstein, and Convention Hall here in Atlantic City. It has been an interesting night, as we mentioned at the beginning of the show. Two familiar names fighting to get back in the picture, and I'm not sure they're all the way into the picture. They're still sort of on the periphery, both Tommy Morrison and Ray Mercer. A reminder once again, we're running a little bit late. Baseball tonight coming up right after Top Rank Boxing.
Ray Mercer getting a draw in an earlier fight, and now Tommy Morrison coming back after having been knocked down earlier in this bout, trying to get a decision against Ross Puritty.
Through eight rounds, Morrison still with an edge, and that's been there almost from the beginning.
And he's boxing more effectively in this round. Except this is really not the posture Morrison wants to be in.
And he got hit with the uppercut.
Yeah. He really is better when he was boxing. There's the my scorecard, and I have Morrison ahead by 1 point in this fight. You can make a case for more. You have him a little farther ahead?
No, I haven't exactly.
Okay. And remember, there's a 2 point round in there in which Puritty knocked him down. When he boxed a little bit, a la the way he did against George Foreman a round or two ago, Morrison was effective in the center of the ring, and that's what he's doing now. He actually wants to make Puritty punch first now. And I can assure you, if Marion Wilson didn't get a decision in the first fight against Ray Mercer, I absolutely will guarantee you that Ross Puritty won't get one against Tommy Morrison in this
one. No, absolutely not.
Even if he were to deserve it.
I was just sitting there thinking, you and I having a one-point fight, I just know none of the judges have it that close.
Call me a cynic, call me a knucklehead, that's the way I feel.
I'll call you smart.
Okay. It's been a kind of lethargic eighth and ninth round, but Morrison has done more than Puritty in both these rounds. And remember, Ross Puritty has never been past six rounds in his career, so this ninth round is something he's never seen before. He certainly wishes he had gotten Morrison out early when he had the chance.
And he had every opportunity. He had 2 minutes left after he had Morrison down.
Back in the sixth round, and he just couldn't get it done.
Crowd starting to get a little restless here with the non-activity.
And we remind you that Tommy Morrison already has a fight planned against Herbie Hyde, the WBO champion, October 28th in Hong Kong. So a lot riding on him winning this fight.
Herbie Hyde, of course, beating Michael Bent, who in turn beat Tommy Morrison to earn that shot. End of round number nine, Morrison wins this round also. Salvaging a reputation here, and he feels fairly confident will win the fight.
Unless, of course, he should get knocked out of the ring.
There is that.
And he's getting whacked right now.
Yes, he is. Down he goes again. And again, a long way to go.
Well, you don't want to get knocked out in the first minute of a round.
Ross Puritty couldn't get him away when he had him down in the sixth round with 2 minutes to go. He's got another chance.
You better go after him right now. Because even with a two-point round here, there is absolutely no guarantee. We have Morrison. I have Morrison ahead by 2 points in this fight. Now, on my card, this knockdown would make the fight a draw.
And Morrison is still shaking. And there's the uppercut again. Boy, it won't take much.
No. And really, on the inside is where Morrison doesn't want to be. He really would almost rather be in the outside where he can't get hit with that uppercut.
But now he's tired. He wants to grab and clutch and hang on.
Well, Ross Puritty, if he's got anything left, better go after it now. He better start winging uppercuts on the inside.
Once again, he might have let Tommy Morrison off. Now, I don't believe Morrison has anything left here either.
And I'll tell you, you better not lose the rest of this round, because some judge may decide to make only a 10-9 round.
I wonder about the round six, because Morrison was fighting at the end of the round. I've been thinking about that ever since.
Yeah, but boy, not only was he knocked out, he almost was knocked out a second time. We'll see. We saw some strange scoring in the first fight. Puritty's not punching.
I was just going to say.
And the uppercut is right there for him again on the inside. It's almost like Ross Puritty's just letting this go.
He has had Tommy Morrison out and has just been unable to finish. And he's not throwing, he hasn't thrown a punch in 30 seconds.
Nothing, hasn't thrown a single punch. Ross Puritty has a chance for a dramatic one right there.
Good left hook, still time.
The uppercut is there for him.
He just caught at it. Straight right, miss. Left hand gets there, uppercut again, missed the right hand. And now they'll take a timeout.
Come on, let's go, baby.
Well, in my mind, what happened right there gives Ross Puritty a 10-8 round. The scoring will be quite intriguing.
Inside of 10 seconds left. Another big round for Puritty, but the question, is it enough? And I'm not sure.
I have the fight a draw, because I had Morrison ahead by 2 points going into that round, and that was a two-point round for Ross Puritty.
Let me say this to you, that man Tommy Morrison
has not given the kind of performance that he wanted to give tonight and has not told people that he is ready for a world championship match. Well, here's the knockdown here in the 10th round, and it came early. There's the uppercut and the hook. Those are the punches that he's been using, and again, the uppercut. The same combination has worked repeatedly for Ross Puritty. And Morrison went down so he wouldn't sustain more damage. It was actually a good tactical move by him. He was hurt there. This uppercut is the one that will hurt him. And from yet another angle, you'll see the hook started the trouble for Tommy Morrison. And then we will see the hook-uppercut combination.
And let's get up to Ed Darien for the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got the scoring, and here it is. Judge John Potteray scored 95-94 Morrison. Judge Frank Brunette scores it 95-93 Puritty. And Judge Shafiq Rashada scored it even at 94-94, which means this goes into the boxing record books as a draw.
Now, that's not a bad decision.
This is a draw.
This was a very close fight. That is not a bad decision.
Moral victory for Ross Puritty, but there's really no such thing. Now, we talked about the fact that both of these fighters were looking to take a step